friends, in today's session we are going to learn a new lesson. It is a very interesting story. Do you like stories? Yes, no? So let's be ready to listen a new story. Okay, what is the name of story? See, here is the name. What? Mona and the Sparrows. Okay, means this lesson is related to one girl named as Mona and related to the sparrows. Okay, now I will read the topic and then I will explain you. So open your English textbook on page number 92. Students, when I am going to read, you have to listen carefully. Okay, let's start. Lesson number 14, Mona and the Sparrows. See, first line. Mona is very happy. She is going to stay with her grandparents, uncle, aunt and cousins in Kolkata. They start packing. Mona has a small shelf of books. She begins to arrange her books. She packs them in a box. She finds a sparrow's nest in a corner of her bookshelf. In the middle of the nest, there are two eggs. See, students, what we learned from the first paragraph? In the first paragraph, we made one new friend. One new friend. Her name is Mona. And Mona is very happy. Why? Do you know? She is very happy because Mona and her family is going to stay with her grandparents, uncle, aunts and cousins. Where they are going? They are going in they are going to stay in Kolkata. Okay, and what we learn in next paragraph? When we are going to any another village, any another city, at that time what we will do? We have to do packing of our clothes, our essential things. And I know what you are going to take when you are going to do packing. You are going to take your all toys. But see, here is a small difference. What Mona wants to take with her? She wants to take books because she have hobby of reading. And when she is going to do packing of books, what she finds? She finds a small nest of sparrows near the bookshelf of Mona. Okay, now what happened next? See the next page on page number 93. The nest is made of twigs. Do you know twigs means what? Twigs means a small branches of tree, straw and dry leaves. Mona loves to watch the mother sparrow as she sits on the eggs. Then the father sparrow brings food for her. See what happened in this paragraph. We know that Mona observed the nest carefully, and the nest made up of twigs, means small branches of trees, straws and dry leaves. And in that nest, what is there? There are some eggs of sparrows, and that's mother sparrow sits on that eggs. And father sparrow, father sparrow brings food for the mother sparrow. Okay, what happened? See the next. After a day or 2 days, Mona sees that the egg shells are broken. There are two yellow colored baby sparrows in the nest. See, isn't it a very interesting story? Because what happened? That mother sparrow had hatches the eggs and what happened? A beautiful small yellow color baby sparrows came out from that eggshells. Okay, and watching that baby sparrows, Mona become very happy. Soon they hop, dance and creep all over. They seems to be saying, what a fun, what a fun. That small baby sparrows dance everywhere and hop everywhere and creep, and the creeping or the sound of creeping says that they are enjoying the new life, and so they are saying that what a fun. All the atmosphere is very happy. They enjoy the new life. Mona watches them with love. Now it is time for her to leave for Kolkata. How can Mona leave the two chicks behind and go to Kolkata? What if the cat eats the chicks? See students, there is a very strong bonding between Mona and that baby sparrows. So Mona feels very love and care for the baby sparrows. And when the day that time came in front of the Mona, and when they want to leave home for going to Kolkata, the care arises in the mind of Mona, and what she feel, if I went now in Kolkata, what happened with that small sparrows? If cat entered our house and eat that baby sparrows, what will happen? So what is the solution in this critical situation? See, in the last paragraph, Mona tells her parents, can we go after a few days, mother? Please, let the chicks grow a little. Let them learn to fly and then we can go. Mona's parents say, yes, Mona is very happy. Soon, the young chicks learn to fly and creep. They are creeping all the time, flying here and there. Actually, they are saying, thank you, Mona, thank you. What is the solution Mona find? Mona asked their parents very pleasefully. She did the request to her parents and says, Mama, we will go after some days when that baby squirrel can fly or creep. Means if cat entered the room, they can fly or they can save their life. And her parents also be ready for that, and they wait for some days when that baby sparrows become young ones and they easily fly or creep. Mona went to the Kolkata, and at that time that baby sparrows says that, means when they are creeping, the sounds meaning is like that, the baby sparrows are saying, thank you, Mona, for saving our life. Isn't it a very interesting and very moral story? Because it gives a moral that we should take care of birds or animals. Okay? समझ में आया students? इस story में क्या है? Mona नाम की एक लड़की है जो कोलकाता जाने के लिए बहुत एक्साइटेड थी, लेकिन उसके बुक शेल्फ के पास एक मेज था, उसमें दो स्पैरोज रहती थी और वहाँ एक थे, उस एग से छोटे छोटे बेबी स्पैरोज बाहर आए, और जब वो दिन आए कि वो कोलकाता निकलने वाले थे, तब वो लड़की को ऐसे, मोना को ऐसे लगा कि अगर हम गए तो कैट इन छोटे बेबी स्पैरोज को खा जाएगा, इसलिए वो रुकते हैं, जब वो बेबी स्पैरोज थोड़े बड़े होते हैं वो निकलते हैं कोलकाता के लिए, एंड एंड में जो क्रीपिंग साउंड है बेबी पैरोज का, वो जैसे कि उस मोना को क्या बोलता है, थैंक यू। सो स्टूडेंट्स यू हैव टू रीड दिस टॉपिक एंड सेंड मी द ऑडियो। थैंक यू।